Survivors have claimed that an American infantry patrol sweeping through their village in March last year executed more than 500 unarmed men, women, and children.
Lieutenant Kelly told me, "Milo, we got another job to do." So we started pushing them off. We started shooting them. So then all together we just used an automatic on them.
That was just shoot at anything. I don't care what moved. I mean, it's just, you know, the person would come out of a hut, bang, shoot. And it's just complete carnage there that day. I was the photographer on the operation of that day. I just photographed everything that I came upon. I was coming up to a group of people who were huddled, and they had some, you know, American GIs surrounding them. One soldier spoke up and said, "Hey, here's a person with a camera." And sure enough, the soldiers backed off, and I moved up. And I took a photograph of these people. You can see the fear in the faces on there, especially the small children. And the older woman trying to protect the daughter. Then all of a sudden, you know, that next instant, automatic fire. They were all shot and they all dropped. I saw them drop to the ground.
We assumed that we were going to hit VC. Only that the civilians would be gone from that entire village. When we went in further, we did start finding people. Like, they started coming out of their house. We're saying, "Well, wait a minute, what the hell is this? They're not supposed to be in here." At first, nobody did anything. Then a couple crazy guys said, "Hey, they must be VC." Some of the guys started shooting.
Once the first civilian was killed, it was too late. Period. Whoever killed the first civilian, that was the end of the situation. It went out of control.
During the day, we started seeing bodies accumulate in the village. Women, kids. I'd never seen anything like that. It was bad.
Vietnamese killed by the Americans.
everybody saw those pictures. The pictures appeared in Life magazine and on nightly news stories over and over again.
We'll now show the pictures published in the Plane Dealer and photographed from the newspaper, accounting for the poor quality. They were taken by Ronald Heberle while on a combat assignment for the Army.
The pictures become almost ubiquitous, and they symbolize evil. And the more they're shown, the more difficult it is to kind of defend what happened at My Lai, or even to look at whatever extenuating circumstances might have been there at My Lai.
Himself. He got on the radio and just said, "This isn't right. These are civilians. There's people killing civilians down here." And that's when he decided to intervene. He said, "We've got to do something about this. Are you with me?" And we said, "Yes."
Thompson now sees a small group of Vietnamese people running along a hedgerow, running for their lives, heading for a bunker. And in hot pursuit of them are the men from Charlie Company.
Mr. Thompson calculated they had less than 30 seconds to live. He told us, "I'm going to go over to the bunker and get these people out myself. And if these American soldiers fire on these people or me when I'm getting them out of the bunker, shoot them."
What's going on here, Lieutenant? Who are these people?
Then mind your own fucking business, boy.
You ain't heard the last of this. Backup teams to evacuate the survivors.
All right. Alpha 7 to I gotta do something. You feel like covering me? I mean, we got a weird situation going on.
Expect confirmation. What did you do?
I'm going back out. Listen to me. If one of those crazy bastards starts firing shots at me, or one of those civilians... You able to return fire?
Yes, sir.
I remember thinking, how did we get into this?
I was probably less than 50 yards from this helicopter. And I remember the door gunners of that helicopter pointing their machine guns directly at me and thinking, oh my God, what are they gonna do?
I'm not here.
We got survivors. Requesting backup assistance.
Yeah, we got a visual on the landing area. We can board them.
Had a group of people gathered up to be taken out. And I landed the helicopter, put them on, and we left with them.
Hugh Thompson, the helicopter pilot, and two of his crewmen, one who was killed in Vietnam, were awarded the prestigious Soldier's Medal for having had the courage to confront their own countrymen in a village called My Lai. Thompson and his crew airlifted a dozen villagers to safety and reported the massacre to their superiors. Hugh Thompson testified about what he saw. 25 soldiers were later charged with murder. They said, in their defense, they were just following orders. Only one was convicted, Lieutenant William Kelly. He served just 3 days in prison for his crime and 3 years under house arrest. Hugh Thompson received a medal for his actions in My Lai. Thompson retired from the Army in 1983 and now works as a counselor for the Veterans Administration in Lafayette, Louisiana. Many people have felt through the past 3 decades that Thompson and his crew were never properly recognized by the Army for their role in ending the massacre. Finally, today they were. Thank you.
Suddenly, an American soldier came in carrying a gun. I saw my father collapse, and then my mother, my grandfather, and my grandmother. They all continued to fall. My brother, younger than me, only 3 years old, suddenly they blasted his head open. One shot and his head blasted onto the floor. Thank you.
we did see bunkers, and we did start throwing grenades into the bunkers. It was about that time that we started hearing the screaming from inside.
Approach, so I pretended to be dead. But the Americans, the three of them came down into the ditch. I looked up a second time, and they came and pulled me out.
I remember taking the boy in my left hand by the back of his shirt, thinking, I hope these buttons are sewn on, or if the shirt lets go, I'm going to lose the boy. Mr. Thompson knew that Quang Nai Hospital wasn't too far away. We left the boy with a nun at the hospital. Told the nun he probably doesn't have any family.
Around 8:30, three American soldiers came to my house. They pushed six of us down into the shelter and threw a hand grenade in behind us. And then they used their machine guns to shoot us down. My entire family was blown into pieces. The only person left alive was me. When there were no more sounds of guns, they came home to bury the dead. I ran home and there was nothing left. My house was burned and destroyed. I couldn't recognize my relatives. They were all burned. There was nothing left. My grandmother, I called to her, Grandma, Grandma. I thought she was almost dead. She raised her hand up. She said, Grandma's here, dear, lying here. They shot me right in my arm. When I called to my sister, she was outside. She just lay there unconscious. But when she heard me call, she woke up and crawled over. The three of us hugged each other and cried. We were covered in blood. They left my village in blood and fire.
bodies here, I later, you know, found and photographed a small kid walking out from the rice, but it was a little higher than this. He was walking out toward the bodies. He was shot in the arm, shot in the leg, walking toward the bodies like he's trying to find his mother. I didn't know the time, but a GI knelt down beside me. He knelt down beside me and shot this kid. And we're both down in a cross position. I stood up and he started standing up and I said, why? He looked at me, turned, just walked away. I yelled at him again, why? Nothing, cold.